Well, ladies and gentlemen, a little bit of a different beginning here for the NWL, switching things up. Instead of hearing me talk to start things off, you got good old Seth Rollins to come out and do the talking for me instead, as he seems to do on a regular basis nowadays here. Almost every time he's on the show, he is out here running his mouth. Could be a good thing, could be a bad thing. Although a huge thing here tonight as he announces that he will be challenging Steve Smooth for the NWL Intercontinental Championship at our next CPV Extreme Rules. We are no doubt going to be having more and more matches announced for that CPV. It is a great night of action where every match has some type of crazy stipulation that ends up hurting at least one person in every match, I would have to say. A fun night that I'm sure you are not going to want to miss, as you're not going to want to miss any of the action we have for you here tonight. First up tonight, though, we have Ted DiBiase versus CM Punk. Alright guys, one-on-one contest between Ted DiBiase and CM Punk starts us off here tonight. And this should be an interesting matchup between these two. Ted DiBiase is coming off of a loss to Randy Orton 2 weeks ago in a no disqualifications match. That was meant to kind of put an end to their differences and their issues that they have with each other. And Orton, in the end, got the better of DiBiase. No doubt upset DiBiase, and he is probably still in a very, very poor mood here tonight, and is going to be looking to take it out on CM Punk in this one. As you can see, he's doing that already, just laying in the punches on Punk. No technical wrestling right there. It's just straight right and left hands into the face and the chest and the body and everything. Is Punk now coming back with a couple chops of his own to try and combat Ted DiBiase's aggressiveness right now. CM Punk's gotta use a little bit more of his technical wrestling skills right now. A little bit more of his speed and agility to try and get away from those punches that are raining out of Ted DiBiase right now. Because now he's picking him up and putting him down on his knee, going after the knees of CM Punk. DiBiase has had his issues with Randy Orton and Triple H recently, especially since him and Cody Rhodes did not win the NWL Tag Team Championships from them at SummerSlam this year. Very disappointing. Did not really compete very well at all in that match. he's shown ever since then a different side of him, a little bit more of an aggressive side, a little bit more disregard for his opponents. I gotta say, it is a little refreshing to see him have a little bit of different style to his wrestling. However, I do not like to see him injuring other people like he attempted to do with Orton and Triple H recently. And like he could possibly do to CM Punk here tonight, too. Gutbuster right there, CM Punk. Falling off the shoulders onto the knee of Ted DiBiase. Then a dropkick to the back of the head. Punk, meanwhile, has kind of been listless right now. Hasn't been in any big-time programs, not since losing the Intercontinental Championship to Steve Smooth. Well, actually, to Agent Smith first, and then fighting Smooth and Smith multiple times for that title. Win for him here might get him a little bit of momentum, maybe try and get him back into some type of title picture. As we already heard at the start of the show here tonight, Seth Rollins is coming after the Intercontinental Champion, Steve Smooth, and his Intercontinental title. That should be a very entertaining match between those guys at Extreme Rules. Seth Rollins has not lost a singles match yet here in the NWL. We're going to see if that's true later tonight. He will be in our main event. More on that will come later. It's DiBiase chucking Punk into the corner turnbuckle, picking him up. And Gutbuster once again. Punk holding at his stomach as DiBiase once again throwing him into the turnbuckle. Full force, picking him up on his shoulders again. Punk wisely is able to get out of it though. Did not allow him to hit the Gutbuster on him again. And delivers a DDT of his own. DiBiase power slam to Punk is now, there's that aggressiveness of DiBiase that we have started to see over the past couple weeks coming into play and just going full throttle against CM Punk right now. Put him down with a suplex, transitioning into a pin, but Punk is able to kick out at one. The resiliency of CM Punk is amazing, as you can see right there. DiBiase was going for a big time move, but Punk reverses into a beautiful, beautiful DDT. Now a submission attempt that DiBiase is able to get out of. And CM Punk's head landing awkwardly on that bottom turnbuckle there. You kind of saw he was kind of like in an upward position there. Not a good spot for his head or neck. Looks like he's okay as he's continuing to fight DiBiase right now in this one. Be interesting to see if that plays a part at all in this match, if maybe DiBiase goes for it. He does have a tendency to go for people's heads, as we saw with Randy Orton slamming his head into a concrete wall. Punk showing a little bit more aggressiveness himself right now against DiBiase. So he might be realizing that's the only way that he's going to be able to gain a victory in this one. DiBiase sidesteps a dropkick and delivers one of his own that sends Punk to the outside. DiBiase will follow him out there, but Punk throws him right back into the ring and gets this thing going again inside. It's the only way you can win this thing, by pinfall or submission. CM Punk knows it. Tossing DiBiase into the corner, high knee into the running bulldog by CM Punk. This could be what he's looking for now. To the apron, off the springboard, elbow to the heart. CM Punk now fired up, looking to put DiBiase away. Stalking his prey right here, right now, on his shoulders. DiBiase's in trouble. Go to sleep. A go to sleep by CM Punk to Ted DiBiase, now going for the pin. DiBiase is in trouble right here, and he gets pinned by CM Punk. Wow. I did not see that one coming, ladies and gentlemen. I thought DiBiase was kind of in control for most of this match, but CM Punk kicked it to another gear there at the end. and found a way to put DiBiase down with the go to sleep. Alright guys, we are getting going with our next match of the night. No slowing down here as it is Sting versus Pennywise in this one. And as you can see on the outside there, Corey Mills is supporting Pennywise, a very awkward support crew there. I don't know Pennywise to be one that usually has someone managing him. But I don't think it's so much about Pennywise as it is about here scouting out possibly interfering with Sting in this one. Corey Mills has had his issues with Sting as, yep, there you go. Grinding his face against the top rope with the distraction that allows Pennywise to pick him up and slam him down. Corey Mills has had his issues with Sting last year a little bit. Stinger got the best of him in that little mini feud they had, but recently it has been reignited, especially with the program that Sting had with Seth Rollins recently. Rollins, of course, beat Sting, but Corey Mills got involved a couple times, teaming up with Seth Rollins. And it looks like him and Sting now have some unfinished business that they are going to try to take care of. But Sting really has to focus on the man that is legal in this match, and that is Pennywise, a very, very dangerous competitor. You can just look at the size difference. Sting is one hell of a man. Big, strong, but Pennywise just dwarfs him in the ring. Well over 7 feet. And a terror of a clown, too. I don't have a fear of clowns, but if anyone did have a fear of clowns, seeing this man in the ring would give you nightmares for weeks. Especially with the moves that he employs on his opponents. They are just pure power. No finesse, no agility, no technical wrestling skills. Just overpower his opponents with punches and kicks and slams from 7 feet up in the air. You're going to do a hell of a lot of damage to your opponent. And if they're not fast and quick and able to get out of the way, it is going to cause a lot of problems. and could force them to lose against Pennywise. Pennywise waiting for Sting to come to the outside, as was Corey Mills there. Now Mills and Sting gaining a little bit of a disagreement. Sting shoving him off, but once again, that allows Pennywise to gain the advantage with the distraction by Corey Mills. Pennywise regains control of this match and throws Sting back into the ring. Managers do help every once in a while. Provide this distraction. Gets your opponent off their game. It allows you to possibly pick up a victory here, as Pennywise, in control of this one, really has been from the get-go. Sting needs to find a way to zone out Corey Mills out there and focus on the man inside the ring that he's facing. If he doesn't, this is going to be a very fast match, as Pennywise is looking to make it that way right now. You can see the pain in Sting's face in those instances when he gets slammed down onto the mat with force by this man. Pennywise again off the splash, but Sting is able to get up off of it and go right back at him. But you can see damage has started to take its toll on Sting, holding at his ribs right now. He's gotten slammed down onto the mat multiple times by Pennywise. Oh wow, what an innovative move right there, as he lifted him up onto his shoulders and then Samoan dropped him down. Alright, I'm going to give Pennywise credit right there. That was actually a move that required quite a bit of technical ability, and he executed that thing perfectly. Amazing. Though you can't do something like that without an amazing amount of strength either. And Pennywise has this. He's able to elbow his way out of the hold of Sting there. And German suplex. Sting being turned inside out right now. Pennywise in complete control of this thing. Basically just playing with his food at this point with another splash there. Sting's in trouble. I don't know if he's going to be able to come back from this one. As he gets tossed into the corner turnbuckle. Pennywise now lifting him up and putting him down with a jackknife powerbomb. Jackknife powerbomb by Pennywise to Sting. This could be it. Stinger's in trouble. Can he get out? No. Sting cannot kick out of that one. Pennywise gaining the victory in this one over Sting. Very dominant performance. Gotta give an assist to Corey Mills there, as he did distract Sting twice, allowing Pennywise to continue his domination of Sting in this one. He utterly manhandled the former NWL champion. So ladies and gentlemen, we are having an impromptu match between Sting and Corey Mills right now. And this is just after Sting lost his match against Pennywise. He took one hell of a beating by that demented clown. And as you can see right now, he has been holding his ribs for that previous match, and he is still holding them right now. Could possibly have a broken rib or something right now. And now he is being forced to compete against Corey Mills right now in this one, who is fresh and ready to go. He was outside the ring watching that match, seeing where the weak points of Sting are. And I gotta say, this is not a good situation for the Stinger right now. I feel really bad for him, as Corey Mills taking it to him. Knee right to the face right there. Kick to the gut again. And a second knee to the face. And I have a bad feeling about this. Corey Mills likes to just continuously do these over and over to his opponents in his matches. This is the fourth one now. please, ref, you gotta stop him from doing this. Come on, come on. This is number 5. Knee right to the face of Sting. Corey Millis is looking pretty proud of himself about it, too. Stinger able to reverse right there into a Samoan drop, but you gotta wonder if he's got really that much left in the tank. After that beating by Pennywise, and now Corey Mills just going after him. Sting is an amazing competitor. Has the heart of a champion, but eventually the body breaks down and won't let you keep going. Sting going for an abdominal stretch on Corey Mills, but you can see he does not have the strength to be able to lock it in fully and really wrench on Corey Mills there. Again, his abdomen is hurting himself, so cannot see him able to do that much damage to Corey Mills right now at this point. Corey Mills is really just picking the bones of a dead animal at this stage. Pennywise beat him down, and Corey Mills is finishing him up. You can see Sting really doesn't have much left in him. Corey Mills really hoping that he mercifully ends this thing for Sting. Rolling out of the ring, Sting trying to buy himself some time, but it might be too little too late. Backstabber right there by Corey Mills. Always do love his backstabber, but in this situation, Corey Mills finally puts Sting away with the surfs up. Is this it? It's gotta be it. I don't see Sting kicking out, and he doesn't. Corey Mills gains the victory in this impromptu match against a beaten down Sting from his previous match. Don't know what this really proves for Corey Mills. He wasn't fully ready for it, wasn't 100%. But I guess the win's a win in his book, as it's a big one against Sting. So ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to take a little break from the action here to hype you up for our next CPV Extreme Rules. It is the one night year where every match has some type of crazy stipulation added to it, and where carnage and mayhem is our bread and butter. We already know 2 matches that will be on the card. The NWL Championship will be defended. Carnage versus Spider-Man number 2, a rematch from SummerSlam. And also we found out just tonight that Seth Rollins will be facing off against Steve Smooth for the NWL Intercontinental Championship. No stipulations have been added to those matches, but it's only a matter of time until something does get added to them. We would also like to thank A Day to Remember for their song, Paranoia. It is the official theme song for Extreme Rules this year. You can hear it playing right now. Go check it out if you like it. Meanwhile, we are going to move on to our next match of the night. It is Willy Wonka versus Triple H. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen, with our next match. Willy Wonka, the Chocolate Man, versus the game Triple H in one-on-one competition. And you gotta think that this is kind of gearing up towards a possible tag team match between their respective teams. As you saw, Triple H is one half of the NWL Tag Team Champions with his partner Randy Orton. Willy Wonka is part of a team with his good old friend the Oompa Loompa. And Wonka and the Oompa Loompa just last week once again downed the Devil and Batista in tag team action. That is now twice. They did it last week and at SummerSlam. That no doubt puts them at the top of the tag team division, right below the tag team champs. And they probably want a shot at the titles. They did beat the tag team champions at the beginning of this season in March. And they are no doubt looking for their opportunity now to get a shot at the title. And I gotta say, I'm all for it. I think these guys have really improved a lot since they first entered the NWL. They've gone from probably a joke and a comedy act to a more serious tag team that could actually, I feel, give Evolution a run for their money. Hell, if they were able to beat the Devil and Batista, one of the most dominant, one of the biggest teams that we have here in the NWL, what can't they do? Why not give them a shot at the tag team champs and see if they can knock them off? This is what it's all about here, guys. Opportunity. And when that opportunity knocks, you take it and you run with it. And I'm hoping that's what happens for the Oompa Loompa and Willy Wonka. I hope that opportunity knocks and they take advantage of it. This match right here is a prime opportunity for Willy Wonka. If he could gain a victory over Triple H, that would be huge. A huge, huge opportunity right here. Triple H knows it as well. He's got to try and put away Willy Wonka. He's a threat to him in his title reign. If he can take him out in singles competition, maybe that gives him some momentum. Maybe that helps him out when it comes to a possible tag team match between these guys. Good opportunity to at least scout him out, know what he's about, know what he likes to do, know possibly where his weaknesses are in his game. That is what Triple H does best. One of his nicknames, besides being the game, is the Cerebral Assassin. You can get inside your mind and play mind games, know what you're thinking before you do, and know how to perfectly combat that. As he gets on top, starts raining down some punches on Willy Wonka right now. So I don't know if it will work necessarily for the Chocolatier here. Willy Wonka is a very crazy man himself. Can never know exactly what he is doing or what he is thinking at any given moment. As you can see right there, spinning off wildly right there. Kind of wondering if he's got something wrong right now. Maybe he's got a concussion or something, because he completely missed Triple H right there. And I think Triple H has had enough of this man. Playtime is over as he delivers a DDT right to Willy Wonka, going for the pin, but a rope break there, a little bit too close. Triple H will have to try and bring him into the center of the ring a little bit more if he wants to try and put him away in this one. Going after the legs now a little bit, weakening him up. Get rid of the base of any of your competitors. They'll give you a distinct advantage. Wonka, once again, back body dropped by Triple H. As you can see, things are not in his favor right now. Triple H with the DX salute right there. Now delivering an elbow to the back of the head and then a neck breaker. Triple H gaining control of this match. Basically putting down Willy Wonka every chance he gets, especially with that clothesline right there you saw. off the ropes, Triple H. Willy Wonka now duking it out in the center of the ring. Wonka brings him down, puts him in a submission, but has not been able to weaken up Triple H enough to get a submission victory, I don't think. As you can see, straight right hand levels Willy Wonka. He needs to find some way to get back into this thing. Starting to pound Triple H's head into the turnbuckle might be the way, but only a couple before Triple H is able to stop him and put him down with another neckbreaker. Now the game going for a submission of his own on Willy Wonka. This is not a good spot for him. Can he get out of it? Yes, he is. Wonka's fighting the good fight right now, trying to stay in it, trying to will his way back in control and come away with another big-time upset victory like him and the Oompa Loompa have had recently against the Devil and Batista, but I think that this time it's a little bit too far out of reach. I don't see him coming back in it, but stranger things have happened. Let's not count him out just yet as he's laying into punches on the corner right before Triple H with another neckbreaker. Every time he gains momentum, Triple H just comes back swinging and puts him down. Gotta feel a little bad for Willy Wonka right now as Triple H is in complete control. Gotta think that he's probably looking to finish this thing up pretty soon here. Wonka is not in command of this thing, and the game could easily put him away at any moment, and that moment could be right now. Triple H grabbing him, locking him up, setting him up for the pedigree. Pedigree by Triple H to Willy Wonka, goes for the pin, center of the ring, not a good spot, and Triple H gains the victory in this one. Very impressive by Triple H in this one, as he basically controlled Willy Wonka from the get-go. Every time Wonka tried to gain a little bit of momentum, tried to gain some traction, Triple H was right there to stop him and not allow him to continue. Very impressive. Congratulations to Triple H.
You think you know?
Alright guys, it is main event time here in the NWL, Seth Rollins versus Edge, the Architect versus the Rated R Superstar. This should be a fun matchup between these two. Seth Rollins, as I have said before, is undefeated here in the NWL, in singles competition at least. Edge is looking to change that, and as a veteran wrestler with experience both here and elsewhere, I would wager that he is more than capable of handing Seth Rollins his first loss. We'll have to see how the Architect is able to respond to this challenge, if he can come up with a way to top Edge in this one. You already heard him at the top of the show, boasting as he usually does. Although usually it's after his match, this time he decided to take over the beginning of the show and claim how he is not a coward. He just took advantage of an opportunity that he saw with Steve Smooth, that he stood up to him and beat him down. And he's going to prove it once again to everyone when he faces Steve Smooth for the NWL Intercontinental Championship at this year's Extreme Rules. I gotta admit, it should be a fun match between those guys. Steve Smooth has been pretty dominant as the NWL Intercontinental Champion, beating the likes of Agent Smith and CM Punk. But Seth Rollins is a whole different creature. He's arrogant, he's boastful, but he can back it up in the ring. Usually those are not qualities you want to have, but he is able to back up every word that he says every time he gets in that ring. Right now, a stalemate between him and Edge. Pele kick right there puts Edge down on the ground, as the wheels are no doubt turning in Seth Rollins' head, as they always are. What should I do next? How should I approach this to beat my opponent? And usually those wheels turn in the correct direction, as more often than not, he is gaining the victory over his opponents. And Edge may just become another name on that list right now in the NWL that is growing by the day. Will Steve Smooth be added to that list come Extreme Rules? That's the big question. Because if he is, we will have a new Intercontinental Champion. Seth Rollins has only been here for just a little over a month now in the NWL, and he could already possibly be holding championship gold. That would be huge for him. Be huge for the NWL, too, at least in his mind. He'll be making it more watchable, as he's said countless times. Takes out Edge with chops right to the chest as he came running in, now throwing him into the turnbuckle. Seth Rollins with a forearm now. Throws him into the other turnbuckle, comes running in once again, but this time Edge wisely sidesteps away. First forearm probably didn't feel too good, so he was like, not gonna take a second one. Instead, I'm gonna try dishing out some punishment to you, Rollins, before getting his arm caught. And Rollins capitalized on it. Now Rollins picking up Edge, but beautiful reversal there by Edge into a DDT. He had Rollins well scouted that time, as he knew he was going to be going for the powerbomb into the turnbuckle. We've seen him do that many times to many different opponents, and Edge knew that he did not want to be one of those guys. Instead, a neckbreaker twisting off the top rope by Seth Rollins, going for a standing moonsault into the pin. Edge could be in trouble right here, right now, too, but he's able to kick out. Edge has to kind of shake it off right now and kind of get his head back into the game, go back after Rollins and try to find a way to gain the victory in this one. Slow down Seth Rollins, kill his momentum. That's what he's got to do. Starts laying in punches and an elbow to the back of the head. It's one way to do it. Rollins picking him up in a gutbuster down on the knee. Throws him into the corner turnbuckle. Goes back at him, but Edge wisely fighting him off. Picks him up in an electric chair drop. Seth Rollins landing hard on his back there. Then a DDT. Edge starting to gain some momentum in this one. Can he gain enough momentum to possibly gain the victory? Going for an abdominal stretch. Submission would win it for him, but Rollins able to break out of it. Grabbing a hold of Edge. Dropkick from behind to the back, the shoulder blade region, as Edge is able to get back on his feet. Goes right back after Rollins with a couple punches, but then gets chops to the chest to put him back down on the ground. Rollins now off the springboard, splashing down on top of Edge, going for the pin off of that. This could be the capitalization that he needs, but Edge kicks out. Rollins going right back at him with a headlock. Now a dropkick right to the face of Edge. Rollins has regained control of this match. Edge, though, looking to find a way to get back into this thing. Off the ropes, toehold drop by Seth Rollins. And now looking to hit what he didn't last time. Can Edge reverse it? No, this time he can't. Powerbomb into the turnbuckle by Seth Rollins. Edge getting up on unsteady feet after that one. Not a good spot you want to be in, Edge. Curb stomp. Curb stomp by Seth Rollins. Going right into the pin, looking to put away the rated R superstar. And he does. Seth Rollins gaining a big time victory in this one against Edge. Kind of a back and forth match between the two of them, but in the end, Seth Rollins gained the victory with the curb stomp as usual. And he looks ready for his match at Extreme Rules against Steve Smooth. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is all the action we have for you here tonight on our great night of action, topped off by another great main event. Seth Rollins continues his winning streak as he sets his sight now on Steve Smooth and the NWL Intercontinental Championship at Extreme Rules. It'll be interesting to see what type of stipulation gets added to that match. As we have already found out here tonight, that the NWL Championship match will now be a ladder match that Spider-Man and Carnage will be competing in. One of those two men is going to climb that ladder and grab that title to become your NWL champion. It's going to be a lot of fun with those two high flyers, seeing what they do, how they put their bodies on the line for the top prize in our industry. Guys, if you enjoyed tonight's episode, please go ahead and leave a like, as well as any comments you may have down below. Otherwise, I'm KJ, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.